Fa Mulan.
Present.
Speaking without permission?
Oops.
Who spit in her bean curd?
Girls, welcome to the 6th grade National Assessment of Educational Progress. Technological devices which provide an unfair advantage are not permitted. If you are in possession of such a device, including but not limited to cell phones, iPods, tablets, calculators, white privilege, parents with a college education, or a household annual income above the poverty line, please power it down now and raise your hand. The proctor will return your device at the end of the testing period.
The whole idea of a standardized test is to test the objective knowledge and ability of students before allowing them to pass the grade. You can't have a functional standardized test if you are constantly changing the standard.
Fred held a test-themed pep rally featuring a monkey mascot.
Time to get funky! Here comes the monkey! Time to get funky! Monkey, 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 monkey!
Teaching the students how to pass exams rather than actually teaching them something important.
We shouldn't hold kids to objective standards. On the other hand, everyone should know the basics. That said, maybe it's less about the testing and more about the teaching. If emphasis put on the learning process instead of the testing process, maybe, I don't know, everyone will win.
Pay attention to us and what we need to learn. Stop putting us in a box and making every child learn the same way when we don't learn the same way.
Okay. This testing looks at me as a number. One test defines me as either a failure or a success through a numbered rubric.
In the lower Hudson Valley, many districts reported that more than 25% of their students opted out.
More than 1,700 elementary, middle, and high school students opted out of taking the PARC test.
There was 5 kids that I was with.
That took the test?
Yeah.
Like, almost the entire auditorium was filled with kids that didn't take it.
Not a single junior showed up to take the Common Core Smarter Balance test.
Students are taking between 10 and 20 standardized tests, depending on the grade, a total average of 113 different ones by graduation.
Every year I do good in school, but I get low test scores on the FCAP, and it feels like a punch in the stomach. This is unfair, and I don't want to lose my opportunity to take my advanced classes or get better education because of this one test.
That is just awful. I take back everything I said about wanting to take a standardized test. In fact, you know what? Bring out the monkey! Bring out the monkey! No! Turn off his music! Turn off it! Do not applaud him! What the f*** is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? You made that little girl cry!
Children will never be able to see all the questions from the test. It's kind of like going for an annual checkup at your doctor, waiting 5 months for the results, and not being able to know which test the doctor ran on you.
Standardized testing. First of all, what is it?
Using the results from commercially prepared standardized tests to make important decisions about educators and children is education malpractice.
When I look back on the great teachers who shaped my life, what I remember isn't the way they prepared me to take a standardized test. What I remember is the way they taught me to believe in myself, to be curious about the world, to take charge of my own learning so that I could reach my full potential.
He's Obama. In third grade, you know? And I want him to develop a love for learning, and I don't want him to attach that anxiety and that stress with education.
Report cards and grade point average measure years of work. Standardized test measures one day. All the emphasis being put on the results and preparing for these tests is killing creativity in our public schools. Teachers are forced to focus on teaching to the test for fear of their job security.
Students who are not proficient readers by the end of third grade are 4 times less likely to graduate from high school by age 19. At poverty, these students become 13 times less likely to graduate on time. Multiply by...
You have to ask yourself, if standardized tests are bad for teachers and bad for kids, who exactly are they good for? Well, it turns out they're operated by companies like all these, and let's...
Please put down your pencils and close your testing booklets. Wait silently while the white teacher who grew up in a wealthy suburb and has never taken a standardized test collects your materials. Feel...
It's time to wake up, people! This one goes after teachers!
Teachers and students.
It's time to get our learn on. And we got a lot to learn, too.
I don't know it all, but I know a few things.
Science. You hear? You check out space, you matter.
It's just science, man.
Don't be a bully.
Don't even be a bully to the bullies. It just makes more bullies.
We can all be awful sometimes.
We can all also be awesome.
It's time to be more awesome.
And that's what's time for.
History. We gotta study it so we don't repeat it.
But if history does repeat itself, then I'm gonna name my pet dinosaur Reginald. I just hope he doesn't eat me.
We can't just study history. We gotta make history.
And history's made by ordinary people.
Ordinary people like you.
And me.
And that guy.
The world's greatest thinkers. Confucius.
Albert Einstein.
Justin Timberlake.
They put their pants on one leg at a time,
just like me.
But I put my pants on one leg at a time while I'm dancing.
You can go by. Yeah.
You're gonna be in the video though.
Life is school, and you gotta show up.
You can't just sleep in. You can't be late.
And you can't just hang out in the bathroom, that's gross.
It's like Walt Whitman said, YOLO. Except he didn't say that, but you would know that if you would read a book, people. Seriously, read a book, any book except the vampire ones. You wanna change the world? You gotta know about it. What if Shakespeare didn't go to school? His plays would be even more confusing. To be or not to be? Is that the question? I don't know what a question is. I didn't go to school. Anybody? Help me out here.
I got a question for you. But why are you teaching the world? How to be boring? How to make the world sad?
No!
No, you're not.
We're teaching the world what it looks like to be awesome.
No matter who you are, somebody's learning from you.
Everybody's a teacher and everybody's a student.
Look for the awesome.
Teachers see things. They see when you're running down the hall. They see when you're passing notes. But they also see the person that we can all become someday. A writer, or a speaker, or Martin Luther King.
Teachers, keep teaching. Students, keep studenting. That's not a word. Sorry about that.
Here's to teachers that see the awesome.
The homework is this. What do you want to teach the world?
Do it.
Let's make some history together.
Because it's simple math.
Together, we're better.
Those girls are a little too loud.
Is there a teacher who inspires you?
Let them know.
This is for teachers everywhere, so share it with them.
We gotta make the world awesome.
Somebody's learning from you.
I'm out.